Hey guys, Debralyn Press here. Artistic director of Westchester, dance, artist in Ossining, New York. This is a recorded stretch class, and it is an intermediate level. I'm filming it during a time where we're all kind of staying indoors and being super safe, and stretching and breathing, that's a wonderful thing to do. So get ready. Before you do this class, you might wanna put on sneakers if the floors are hard like these and jump around, or take a walk around the block, but I will give a little warm up too. Okay, so this is a stretch class specifically for the people that I love to stretch with. You know who you are, and we'll be making different ones all the time, but this is gonna be a really good basic stretch class because you probably haven't been stretching, and it's gonna open up your hips and your hamstrings are gonna get longer and you're just gonna feel so good. So please, please take this class, which I made for you guys. And if you are not somebody that I know and you're doing this class and it's helping you, God bless and enjoy. Okay, so we're gonna start with our feet right under our hips. And just stand there for a minute. Imagine your pubic bone and your tailbone coming together. Your shoulders are down, close your eyes. I'm gonna breathe. Breathe in. And breathe out. Another one, breathe in. And breathe out. Let's start. Take your arms up. Press your hands out to the side. Take your head and heart forward and down. Bend your knees, circle your arms, and come on up. And again, arms go to the side. Roll your chest down. Head and heart. And down. Bend your knees, come on up. Again, another time. Go down. Rolling down through your back. Now breathe in. Exhale, stay there again.
Breathe in.
Exhale.
One more time, breathe in.
Exhale. Bend your knees, come on up. Grab your right hand, lean sideways, look under your armpit. Take a few deep breaths in. You're allowed to let your hips go side, make it even deeper, looking up under your armpit. Inhale. Exhale, inhale to come up. Other side, leaning sideways, few deep breaths. And inhale to come up. And let's open up our feet to second. We're just gonna do a few pliés to say hello. So demi-plié, demi-plié. And stretch. Demi-plié and stretch. Grand plié. Go down. Two, three, four, and up. Let's do that again. Is your tailbone where it should be? Demi-stretch. And we're going to go down. Down, two, three, four, and up. Another time. Demi. And stretch, demi, and stretch, and go down, two, three, four, and up, six, seven, eight. Take a nice plie down. Press one shoulder down, look over the other. Breathe. And the other side. Both elbows on your hips. We're just saying hello. We haven't gotten to anything yet. You guys know that, right? Toes forward. Just release your head down to the floor. Walk your hands forward. Press your back through your upper arms. Nice breath. Let's hang over the right leg. Walk yourself over, it doesn't matter if you reach your foot, it can be right here, it doesn't matter. Just hang it over. Big breath. walk yourself to the other side. Deep breaths. Another one. Let's just make one more happen. Taking your left arm up to the ceiling. Doesn't matter if you're here. Doesn't matter. Try and open your rib cage up to the ceiling. Your neck, make sure you look down. Coming back to the middle, bend your knees and roll. Great. Bring your feet together. Let's roll one shoulders back. Roll in front. Roll them back. And front. Let's contract. Contract your body so it's a C. And now arch back a little bit. I'm going to do it sideways so you can see. Here we go. Go contract. 2, 3, 4. Press back. 2, 3, 4. Contract. Press. 3, 4. And back. 2, 3, 4. Contract. 2, 3, 4, press back. One more time. Contract, 2, 3, 4, press back. Take your hands. Grab your fingers. Now lift your head and heart up to the ceiling. Don't drop your head back, just look at the ceiling. And we're gonna take that over. So now we're going over, your feet are hip width apart. Try and pull your arms to the wall in front of you. We're here, we're going to open up the shoulders, so let's take our right shoulder to the right leg. You know we have to stretch our hamstrings a lot, right guys? Other side. Trying to use your hands to move your shoulders here. Up to the ceiling. Come on down, bend your knees. Come on up. Okay, I think we're ready to go down to the floor. So here we go. We're on the floor. So, let's just roll down. And we're gonna bring our right leg to our chest. It doesn't matter if this leg can stay on the floor. If it can't, just put it there. So bring your leg up and roll your ankle. And reverse. And now just put your knee into you. And again, you're keeping your opposite hip on the ground. I don't care which leg you're doing, just make sure you switch them, okay? Let's take this leg to the armpit and just open that up to the armpit. So your opposite shoulders down this time, compress into the ground, and we're just gonna breathe. And exhale. And breathe. And exhale. Now we're gonna lift our foot to the ceiling, grab the outside edge of your foot, and we're trying to pull our knee down to the floor. So pull down. Let's stay here a little while, guys. You should maybe feel a stretch here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Okay. And now we're going to take this leg and put it on top of the other knee. Reach in between the space. We're going to grab onto your shin or your calf, and we're in this nice position. So try and push the leg that's up. You probably used your right leg first. our first stretching class since the studio was closed. So find another spot. And exhale. Again, inhale. And exhale. We're going to do an isometric exercise now. It's going to really help. So what you're going to do is grab your leg that is underneath the one that your ankle is on top of. Does that make sense? You're going to pull your leg towards you with your hands as you push away with your bottom leg. So here we go. And you're really trying to open up that top knee. Hopefully you'll feel this in a different part of your body. Keep on pulling. And now release, and again, pull. And release, so you're pulling with your hands and pushing with your leg. And release now. Try, as you're doing this, to lengthen your tailbone so that it's long on the ground. Okay, let's just put our leg down and do the other side. We're not ready for the other part of the leg things yet. Pull this knee into your chest. We're going to circle. Chest. Now open the knee to the armpit and you're pulling. And exhale. And again, inhale. And exhale. And now we're going to take the outside of your foot. In yoga, they call this happy baby. Down to the floor. So it's like your foot is standing on the ceiling. And pull down. These are hip openers, you know. Bring it up, reach through, and you're just gonna stay here and gently find a place. And if you press your tailbone forward, you're gonna feel more of a stretch. Your knee that is on top is pushing forwards towards the front of the room. So let's breathe here a little bit. Exercise. Take your hands, pull them towards you, and push with your leg away. Push as hard as you can and open up the top knee. And you're pushing. And release. And relax. Do it again. Pull and push. Enough of that. We're going to come back to lying on our backs in just a little bit. Let's roll over to the side and come on up. Hey there. We're going to bring one leg in right here. Okay, and the other foot is going to be flexed. Take your right arm into the inside and just reach sideways. Now this is for your side body and your leg. So right now we're flexing the foot. And you're just reaching, look up under the armpit, and just breathe. Flex the foot hard. release the leg and go down. It doesn't matter how far you go. See if you can bring your head behind that knee. You're curling over. Let's come back up again on that side. So here we are. If you want to, you can grab your toes and look up under your armpit. It's up to you. I'm feeling a nice stretch right here in my side, so I'm just going to stay here flexing that foot. Reach forward over the leg. One more time. Up this way. Okay, now take that arm and push it back like you're pushing against a wall and look up at the ceiling. And take this arm and push against that leg. Now we're going to rotate the back of the hand to the spine and try and open up the top shoulder even more. It's a shoulder opener again. I have super tight shoulders. I know some of you guys don't, but try. If I'm doing something that you don't like, do your own thing. You know that you know what to do. And come on up, other side. So here we go, flexing that foot. And go side. Hope you guys are keeping busy. Art projects, organizing your closet, and face the leg. Relaxing the foot this time. Try and let your head come to the outside of the knee, and try and take the inside shoulder to the inside of the knee, so you're really turning. Let's flip up again. Here we go. The more that you take the hip that's opposite the leg that's out and press it to the floor, the bigger stretch in your side you'll get. And over the leg. Back like it's against a wall. So you should feel this in the shoulder, maybe. And behind the back, opening up your shoulder. With our back and went down at the very beginning, we're going to do that over our legs. So here we are. We're going to start with just hanging over your leg. Just hang over.
So just hang over for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Now flex your feet until your heels come off. Keep your back straight. And you should just feel a stretch in the back of the legs. Your feet till heels come off the ground, keeping your head in line. So you're looking forward about 8 inches in front of your feet. Okay, over again.
Now this time, Again, lengthen the back. And take your head down. Another time, lengthening the back. And release down. Final opportunity, lengthen the back. And release down. Let's hang out here for a minute. Take your right hand to the outside of the left leg, staying there, put your head down behind that knee. Now flex your feet. Other side, relax your feet, pull your head down behind the knee. Now flex your feet.
Starting to feel warm. We're going to stand a minute, do a couple of things standing before we do splits, and we also never stretched out our Achilles, so we're going to do that with our good old downward dog. So cross your ankles, come up here, and we're going to go to downward dog. Now you should feel kind of warm right now, so pressing your back in between your arms, let's stay there for a minute. Now bend your knees and lift your heels up. Let your chest come to your thighs, and now press your heels down. Pressing with your hands, your fingers are open, your palms are against the mat, you're rotating your elbows forward. One more time, bend those knees, lift those heels. See if you can feel a stretch in your Achilles, and now take your heels down. Now I want you to do anything with treading. I want you to tread with your body, with your feet, and you can move your body any way that feels really yummy. Any way that feels like, yes, I'm doing this and it feels so lovely. I'm so glad that this is happening, yay. You can move your upper body, anything like that. Okay, we're going to take one leg high in the air behind you and open up your hip. And press both hands evenly into the ground. You should maybe feel this in your standing leg and also a hip opener. We're going to make a big circle now. We're going to take our knee to the inside leg, the outside leg, and back up. And again, inside leg and outside leg, back up. Again. Outside leg, back up. One more time. Inside leg, outside leg, back up. Now hold, push up, push back. Curl your knee into your chest. Step forward with that foot for your runner's lunge. Good old runner's lunge. So we're pressing down with that hip. I know some of you guys don't feel this one, but I want you to take the leg that's front, push that hip back, and take the back hip and push it forward and see if you feel more of a stretch. Make sure your knee is opening up, of course. Put the back foot down, press up, arch back, sink into the subsocket. And again, try and keep the front hip back. If you'd like to, just take your arms up. And arch back, yay, wonderful. And now we're just going to flex this foot, stay up here and lean over that leg, that hamstring again. Coming forward again. Okay, we're here, we're gonna take a nice twist. So take this arm that's not in front, end up and twist. Try and open up your chest. Take both forearms, open up the front foot a little bit, take both forearms to the ground, and
stretch there. Now allow this front leg to open so you're on the outside of that foot. This is a really great stretch in a weird part of your body that you probably haven't done before. Take the top foot and open it up and you're staying here in your forearms.
I hope you guys can feel that.
I know I can feel that. Coming back, we are going to do pigeon. Take the front leg, you know this one, make it parallel with the front. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to grab your, if you have a mat, grab it. If not, I'm just going to lean back. I have a very tight upper back. You're going to grab my mat and lean up. If you're somebody who's super flexible, you can just enjoy grabbing your foot behind your head or something. And coming all the way down.
Relax. Tense your fingers. Walk your hands forward and relax again. Walk your arms back.
Circle. So take your knee to the inside elbow, the outside elbow, and back up. And again, to the inside elbow, the outside elbow, and up. Inside elbow, outside elbow, and up. Inside elbow, outside elbow, and up. And stretch that leg and push. Foot in, let's go to our runner stretch. Pressing down with that hip. Shoulders are down, right? You guys know. And the knee goes down, the foot goes down. Coming up to here. You know that to open up that knee. Lift your arms up. About your hips. The front one goes back, the back one goes front, you're hanging over. Let's come to pigeon. If I'm forgetting something in sequence, I'm sorry. My first time I'm doing this, guys. So your pigeon, reach back. Find where your body needs a stretch, right? Boy, I should put my hair in a ponytail. How about you? Well, I know what I forgot, the heinous one. We're gonna do it anyway. Tense your fingers, go forward. Bring your hands back. Go back to your runner stretch. Now what you're going to do is you're going to go on the outside of this foot and stretch down. Feel it?
Oh, wait a minute. Back to your runner stretch. Lift this arm up. Try and take your ribcage to the ceiling. Open up that foot a little. Come down to your hands and now roll onto the outside of the front leg and hang over. It's a very deep stretch. I hope you can feel it. Okay, so we are going to not do the splits yet even. We're going to come back over here, wide parallel. Take your right arm behind you and your left arm in front. Look under your armpit. Use your own mind and body to decide. Should you pull with the front leg against the floor? Does that give you more of a stretch somewhere, like in the outside of your lower leg? What's happening? And switch. Looking under the front armpit. Hanging out over your left leg. Me out over the right leg. Do you feel any more flexible than when you started? By goodness sake, I hope so. Take your hands behind you. Pull your head down. Okay, so now we're going to do this one. Bend and flex. Opening up this knee. Hopefully you feel it in the back of the leg. And other side. Other side. Other side. Okay, other side. Let's stay here for a little bit. Open up that leg and really breathe into it. I think that Bob Marley just makes me feel like I'm in the islands and relaxing. And other side. Okay, here we go. Back to your right stretch. First side. Go back. Sitting back if you can, if you have good knees. I mean, knees that don't hurt, not that all knees are good. Flex the front leg. You can lie down on it, or you can stay halfway up. They're both good stretches. Forward again. One, two, three, four, and back. In front. And back. The more you bring the leg that's up, that back in the front makes it. We're gonna split. Split. So stay right on top of your split. If you can, grab your back foot and pick it up to your head. I know, you know who I'm talking to. We're staying here. Grab your front leg, you're gonna take your body forward to it and pull it up to your body. So your face is in your,
by your knee. You can use this other hand to push your body closer to your leg. Stay here. It doesn't matter if you're really at your leg, you could be way out. You're gonna make yourself feel a stretch, I know you are. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna roll towards the bottom leg. So we're gonna roll and grab this leg.
And we're still stretching. So
These floors are really hard, so.
Kick twice and stretch your leg. Kick twice, stretch your leg. Okay, now bend and flex, stretch and point. And again, bend and stretch, flex and point, carry our legs side. If you're flexible enough, reach over the top of your head and pull it. Try and lengthen the bottom hip socket, then lengthen the bottom leg. If you want more of a stretch, flex that foot. You can flex both feet. Okay, let's do the other side. So here we go. Okay, the runner stretch. Slide into our split on this side. Slide into the split. And if you feel the need, if you can do it, grab your back foot, take it to your head. So we're here. So you can bring your back hip forward and your forward hip back here too. You'll feel more of a stretch. Lie down. Take your leg up to your face.
Yay! You can use your other hand to push yourself towards your
leg. Okay, so here we are. Now we're going to roll towards the bottom leg and round the top leg and take it up. Stretch. Everybody has one leg that's tighter than the other, you know? Kick twice and stretch. Kick twice and stretch. Bend and flex. Stretch and point. Stretch and point. Take your legs side to the ear. If you can, reach around on top and grab your foot. It's amazing how your body can do a lot of strength training and I'm so much less flexible. Couple more things. Let's sit in this position. You know, the bottom leg comes in, the front leg goes over. Sit up very straight. Take your arm up that's opposite the leg on top, put it in front, other hands back. We're slowly going to twist to the back. Start with your lower body, your abdomen, then your rib cage, then your chest. Your head is the last thing that moves. Inhale, exhale, twist. Inhale, exhale, twist. We're relaxing into this twist. You can imagine this like a mop full of like dirty water and it's being wrung out. And clean water is coming in. Inhale, exhale the chest. Side and take it.
really towards the opposite shoulder. And one more time, take a twist back. And another twist in the other direction. Lay the top knee on top of the bottom knee. And we're just gonna go forward and down.
Some of you are gonna be lying all the way. Some of you are gonna be very high. It doesn't matter, we're just stretching.
Should be on the ground. There's so many things I'm forgetting to say, but you guys know what they are. Arm up, putting it down. Other arm goes back, inhale. Exhale, lower body. Inhale. Exhale, rib cage. Inhale, exhale, chest. Shoulder and twist back again. Keeping the back shoulder down, by the way. Other way. Okay, now this knee lays on top of the other knee. We're going to go forward and down. Dropping your head is the first thing that happens. It's fine if you're right here, your hands touch the floor, don't even. Elbows are next, forehead's next, chest and stomach is next. And then if you're all the way on top, you can roll around back and forth, through and through. Hello, Bella. Slow, go down. And other side. Let's tilt our head to the right. Take the other arm to the ground, hand to the ground. Take the right arm up, reach around, tuck your chin, pressing the left shoulder down. Feel the stretch. I can feel this all up my arm, but everybody's different. Tuck your head a little more. Don't pull too hard, it's gentle. And release, roll your head forward using your stomach. Take your head up, other side. This way. Other hands on the ground. Tuck your chin a little. Feeling that nice stretch. Your chin a little more. Coming up, reach your hands behind your head. Let your elbows just bring your head forward.
just stretching the back of the neck so gently.
Coming up, final stretch. What we're going to do is we're just going to put this elbow on the ground and tilt the head. You can try and keep the opposite hip down. You probably won't be able to, but you might be able to. Try and take your chest to the ceiling if you can. Other side. Oh, I forgot one of my favorite ones. We'll do it next time. Come on. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. I love you. Thanks. And I hope to see you on Zoom. And also, for more classes. Have a great rest of your day. And keep on breathing, guys.